guys doing? You okay now?
Yeah.
Good. 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 Well, welcome back. We'll start off with a little Scottish, Irish, and Galician music for you. From Galicia. Yeah, a little piece called Chaupana. Okay, goes like this.
Thank you.
folks here that are probably not originally from here, right? But a lot of you are from small towns, maybe? Well, here's a song written by a fellow from Maine, all about coming from a small town.
Here we go.
There's a new superstore on the outside of town. It's the very first thing that you see. The people are coming from miles around, 'cause the merchants on Main can't compete. They got records and rugs, groceries and drugs, on acres of cold concrete floor. And when I walked in, my head started to spin. I forgot what I came in for. And I miss Main Street, where everyone knew you by name. And I miss Main Street. My, how this little town's changed. There's no stopping it, I guess. It's all part of progress, trading the old for the new. And I miss Main Street. What in the world is this world coming to? Now the old movie house is all boarded up, just waiting to be torn down. Between the new mall and the damned wrecking ball, they're making short work of my town. And folks these days just spend their pay in a discount atmosphere. And nobody knows where the money all goes, but it stays around here. And I miss Main Street, where you knew everybody by name. My, how this little town's changed. There's no stopping it, I guess. It's all part of progress, trading the old for the new. And I miss Main Street. What in the world is this world coming to? Just a kid. If only you could see it now, the way that I once did. Yeah, I miss Main Street, where you knew everybody by name. And I miss Main Street. My, how this little town's changed. There's no stopping it, I guess. It's all part of progress, trading the old for the new. And I miss Main Street. What in the world is this world coming to? Yeah, I miss Main Street, where everyone knew you by name. And I miss Main Street. My, how this little town's changed. There's no stopping it, I guess. It's all part of progress, trading the old for the new. And I miss Main Street. What in the world is this world coming to? Well, that was written by none other than David Mallet.
Yeah.
And he wrote this. this song about Prince Edward Island as well, during his travels. Must have landed there some winter night and ended up at a kitchen party. The St. Anne's reel being played. Edward Island, waiting for a ship to come and find him. A one-horse place, a smiling face, some coffee and a tiny trace of fiddling in the distance far behind. Down across the counter then, a shy hello, a brand new friend, walked along the street in the wintry weather. A yellow light, an open door, a welcome friend, there's room for more. Together. He said, I've heard that tune somewhere before, but I can't remember where. Was it on some other friendly shore? Did he hear it on the wind? Was it written in the sky above? I think I heard it from someone I love. Never heard it sound so sweet since then. Great to have her in see her when we get the chance to come down this way, and Janine Rendell. Let's give her a big round of applause.
I know. Alright.
We'll take it down just for a minute here and do a. This is a lovely tune. It was a fellow, great composer, and there's two of me. Now there's one of me. Tick, 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 tick. Now there's one. There we go.
Sorry.
And, And he's a fellow by the name of Jerry Holland. And I know Jerry's been around these parts when he was living. And we lost him a few years ago, but this is a tune that I met Jerry when I was about 9 years old. He played for me to step dance many, many moons ago. And of course, I got to, through the years, to know Jerry as a fiddle player, and then I started. Wonderful, wonderful man. He wrote this little piece here called Tears.
Thank you.
request. A little tune about a fella. You can't perform with a flaccid skin, that's for sure. Okay. Well, we were talking earlier, a lot of folks went to Prince Edward Island back before there was a Confederation bridge, and you had to take the ferry to get from Cape Tormentine, New Brunswick, to board in Prince Edward Island. And the ferry was called the Abigwate, remember? And this is the story of a fellow that I'm kind of in the same boat with. Because I've lived in Prince Edward Island in Guernsey Cove now, it'll be 39 years this summer. I moved there the year that Richard Wood was born. It was fate, I'd say.
There you go. Yeah.
But my birth certificate says Saskatchewan. So, in a lot of places in Prince Edward Island, I'm terminally and permanently from away. This is the story of a poor fellow by the name of Hector Jelly, who was in the same boat. Oh, my name is Hector Jelly. And this is my complaint. My twin brother is an islander, but holy smoke, I ain't. I was born upon the Abigwate, which came as quite a shock. But some idiot cut my umbilical cord before the ferry docked. Now my younger brother, Borden, he loves to rub it in that he's the native islander and I'm his distant twin. I was always Tonto, he was always a lone ranger. He got all the cuddly names, people called me Stranger. So is it by default, or is it by injection? Is it come by honestly, or is it an infection? Someone tell me please before they put me in the earth. How in the name of God do I become an islander? Now I love the girl from Carlton and she said she'd be my wife. The third generation islander, I've known her all my life. But she called it off the night before and phoned me up to say I could never tell a child of mine his daddy's from away. So is it by default or is it by injection? Is it come by honestly, or is it an infection? Someone tell me please before they put me in the earth. How in the name of God do I become an islander? In my long and lonely later years, my prospects looked so cruddy that I went to seek my roots at the Institute of Island Studies. The expert said that when I die, I can lie in the family pot. But even genetically qualified, an islander I'm not. At age 95, I finally died and went to the pearly gates. Surely to heaven by now, I thought I'd found my rightful place. But St. Peter told me, Hector, we'd love to let you stay. Heaven's full of islanders, but you're still...
No way!
So is it by default? Or is it by induction? Is it come by honestly, or is it an infection? Someone tell me please before they put me in the earth. How in the name of God do I become an islander? Well then the devil saw me coming, and he licked his lips with glee, contemplating all the tortures he'd inflict eternally. But God yelled down from heaven, be gentle, Lucifer. He's been through hell already, trying to be an islander. So is it by default, or is it by injection? Is it come by honestly, or is it an infection? Someone tell me please before they put me in the earth. How in the name of God do I become an islander? Well, is it by default, or is it by injection? Is it come by honestly, or is it an infection? Someone tell me please before they burn me with the worst. How in the name of God can I be reincarnated or modified? How in the name of God do I become an islander? Different sound too. You can hear more of that kind of drone-y kind of double strings. So you get a lot of that, which is almost imitating what the pipes would be doing with the, with the drones. So it's kind of cool. There's some great tunes here. All right, here we go. Thank you. very much. A couple of nice little Irish jigs there for you from a great group called Nomos. And yeah, nice kind of gentle jigs.
Yeah.
Love playing those. Yeah.
Cool.
Sure.
Do
it
for
it.
Line her up.
Sure. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to do a medley here that'll probably take about 40 minutes.
Come on up. You want to play that with us?
Sure.
Yeah, come on up. All right. Welcome back to New Metal. Let's give a round. I know.
It's really hard to know the bottom end, isn't it?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. You're not going to right.
The bass.
Yeah. I know.
You're just playing percussion, basically.
Yeah.
So anyway, as you know by now, of course, we are here from Prince Edward Island, and we did bring some brochures all about a festival that happens in Prince Edward Island the last 2 weeks of June every year. It's called the Festival of Small Halls, and the little tiny halls all across the island. There's in 2 weeks there's 40 shows, and everything from Americana to Irish to maritime fiddle music to storytelling to singer-songwriters, and it's a great little festival. So if you want to grab one of those brochures, even if you can't make it up this year, it's usually the last 2 weeks of June, and it's beautiful up there the last 2 weeks of June. It's not necessarily hot, but it's the most beautiful, all the colors you want, and a lot to go up there in June, that's for sure. So we're going to finish off with the Prince Edward Island Shanty. Meaning that at the end of every round, I sing, you guys sing back the words, Prince Edward Island. It's pretty easy. And then we'll head into a medley of fiddle tunes called The Guitar Player and The Piano Player. Hang on.
That's right. That's good.
All right, here we go. Thanks, you guys.
Thank you very much. Here we go.
Come on, you folks, and sing this song. To the diligent ones,
Prince Edward Island.
Here's at the hearts of colorful, inspirational making stones. Tonight we'll sing, tonight we'll shout,
Prince Edward Island.
When winter ends, it's a month of rain,
Prince Edward Island.
But then it gets too hot and we all complain,
Prince Edward Island.
Sparkling water spills a green that sea, the bow behind the tree. Tonight we'll shout!